Okay, let's bring in Mayuresh Joshi into the conversation as well. Mayuresh, let's talk about the big bank numbers. You know, a couple of these banks, Indian Bank in particular, I mean, they've shown some promise this time around. Is there any PSU that you are willing to back, looking at earnings or perhaps because of the recapitalization expectations?
So afternoon, Surbhi. Yes, I think the recapitalization story has turned the tide in favor of PSU banks. And secondly, if you look at the numbers on a low base were always expected to be a little better, both in terms of reported asset quality as well as the kind of growth that one would expect from NII. Nothing taking away, I think Indian Bank is something that I've been liking for the past few months, and a very good set of numbers. If you look at GNPA 6.67 compared to more than 7% on a quarter-on-quarter basis, the net NPAs have come at 3.41% compared to 4.05%. So there has been sequential improvement along with loan growth and credit quality actually picking up. So in that sense, again, I think a few of these banks are looking very, very attractive. So I think Indian Bank is something that I continue to remain positive about based on the premise that the management is hopeful over the next few quarters of getting GNPAs below the 5% mark. And again, NII growth expected to be very, very strong. A dark horse in this entire race can be Vijaya Bank. So any decline becomes a very good accumulative opportunity in my opinion. Again, GNPAs at 7.03% compared to 7.3%. The net NPAs came at 4.86% compared to more than 5% on a quarter-on-quarter basis. So there's been a substantial improvement in terms of asset quality. Even in terms of NII growth, 22% NII growth exhibited by the bank in the quarter gone by. And though the provisions have gone up, I think it's more aging related at this point of time. So apart from large caps like SBI, yes, I think Vijaya Bank on declines seems to be a dark horse candidate from me within the PSU banking space.
Okay, we'll take a break on that. Oh yes, let's take some final thoughts then from our guests. Mayuresh, thoughts on Reliance Capital after the kind of decline that we saw today?
Yes, I think it is on expected lines, but largely again, I think if one really has to look at a mid-cap universe from a bottom-up approach, my own sense is that there were a couple of results which were quite good. So GE, T&D had a good set of numbers in my opinion, and this entire transformers rally has been driven in terms of expectations of the spending patterns and the capital outlay for the T&D department itself. So largely itself, again, you probably expected to see higher double-digit growth in terms of revenue. The margins, which were in single digits of 5-6% for the industry as a whole, whether it be GE, T&D, whether it be Voltam, whether it be Drill, I think the margin improvement is expected to happen with good orders coming through, and the BIS certifications expected probably to weed out the unorganized players into the market. Consolidation is going to be extremely critical. So order flows are expected to come from the state transformer boards with the outlay, as I mentioned, and that is going to have a significant outlay. Specialty chemical players, again, remains a very interesting play with a lot of norms that are basically levied by the Chinese authorities in terms of both effluent discharge. And again, primary producers probably seeing some issues in terms of material and labor costs going up. You're probably seeing specialty chemical players also expected to do well in terms of margin improvement and efficiency in terms of capital ratios. So Shree Pushkar, Bodal probably remain very, very interesting place out there in that space as well. So Reliance Capital, I think it might consolidate, but I think there are far better other mid-cap counters from a bottom-up approach that can do well over the next 4 to 6 quarters.